Welcome back to Let's Play Tales of Zestiria HD Blind. Last time we... In like the last two episodes, we took down two crucibles. Holy wow. We are rocking these things. And I even one-shot it last episode. I didn't do it as quickly as I certainly wanted to do it, but I one-shotted it. And that's all that... Okay, that's not all that matters, but that's freaking awesome. That's my power of argumentation, guys. Shut up, it's cool.
What's that?
I don't know. I trade on something. I assume it's not this white thing. No, it's not the white thing. Is it these pretty flowers? It is not the pretty flowers. What the hell is it? It's not those flowers. I have no idea what's that about. But it was obviously something. Maybe it's on top of this thing. Maybe it's on top of spaghetti. I'll cover in cheese. You know the song. Okay, it's not this just thing in general. Well, there's an abandoned city. That's super wicked, not awesome. Grape gel, wow. We are getting a late game if I'm getting grape gel. What the heck did you trigger all? Oh, hi. Thank you.
That was a difficult battle. Let's
that was not a difficult battle. You are a liar. Interesting, there was a dark bottle and across the way was a holy bottle. That is certainly a thing, but what did you see, Saray? Get away from me. Alright, come on guys. Just die so I can find whatever this freaking thing is. Oh wow, I apparently just died. That's what I get for not really paying attention. Now, what did you trigger on, Saray? Oh, I'm so frustrated by not knowing what it is. I caught off and it was like right here. It wasn't that. I do not see anything special. I'm getting really frustrated because I don't see anything special. Not this thing, is it? No. I have no idea what it is. I have no idea what it is. Repetition is key, guys, and I am repeating that I don't know what it is so that you will believe me.
Is this the village of the saint?
No one's here.
Not so sure about that.
Yeah, I'm not feeling this. Every single time we find a village like this, there's something terrible inside. There's a treasure chest between two gravestones. And, yep, another one of these damn things. God dang! How many times are we gonna run into this? Why are you guys always here? Okay, so you are not resistant to Earth, and you're very weak to physical. Damn it! Okay, so now that she's not resistant to me anymore. Fiend, so up and down is good. That's the only one though. Okay, we're doing this again, huh? Oh, come on! Die at once? Who do you think you are? You can't kill me, I'm too amazing. Alright. Ha ha ha! I don't know why you're laughing, because you're getting your butt kicked. Damn it.
You're pretty much screwed.
We are pretty much screwed. Okay. Life bottle me back up. Alright, come on. Alright. This is the saint?
You did nothing to help! You let disease take the children one by one! None of it was my fault!
So the saint... God dang, how many times do I have to go through this?
Fight left in her?
Dang it. We couldn't purify her either.
Not doing so hot, are we?
Is this the same person over and over again that keeps getting stronger?
Yeah. It must have been the saint. Betrayed by the people she believed in.
Medusa-type Hellions tend to be women with high degrees of self-righteousness and hatred.
Oh, so that's why you freeze when they glare at you.
The saint was a nun. Maybe the church in Pendrago would have some info on her.
Let's check it out.
Interesting. Someone said that in comments. I kind of wondered how in the world I was supposed to figure out to go to Pendrago to read about this random Hellion. But yeah, it's because of this. Because whenever you... So, apparently, if I'm understanding this correctly, very, very holy women that, you know, aren't able to realize their dreams will become Hellions whenever they give up on themselves? What is this exactly? It's a very dark ruin, that's what it is. Once again, I'm not entirely sure if I should be here or not. That was interesting. There was a ghost following me. I like the dark temple. That seems kind of awesome. This is a very undead-centric location, it appears. Seems like I mostly get away from all of them, though. It doesn't look like the wraiths can outmaneuver me. It also doesn't seem the wraiths can go through those, and they really should be able to, you know? Nothing there. Nothing but the rent. Well, hi there! Nothing that way. Nothing that way. This room is eerily close to a swastika. I've just got to say that. I don't much care for it, I got to tell you. So that's just a straight up wall. There's no getting through that. Well, hi there, buddies. Bye there, buddies. Wonder why all the Hellions want to kill me so much. I mean, I guess the Hellions just want to kill everyone, but man, they all... It seems odd that there's this many Hellions in the world, and yet the vast majority of humanity isn't really aware of them. You know, if they react to everyone this strongly... I don't know why they wouldn't. Let me head and go back this way, just to see what's down this corridor. Are these guys still following me? Wow. I'm hanging in there. I'm hanging there pretty well. I'd have to say that puzzle's repeated too many times. It's like, once you figure it out once, I don't know why they keep giving it to you. Oh, are you gonna know what to do with the red gems this time? Yeah, I am. Alright. How in the world is there an herb growing down here? That seems impossible. Alright, nothing there. I didn't think so, because the map can kind of tell there was nothing. Alright, nothing that way. And this guy wants to be my friend. Oh, couldn't get past him.
We've seen other giant Hellions, but this one's so huge! If you want to live,
let's just get out alive!
Not interested in fighting that guy. That was kind of an interesting little, exchange of dialogue, though. I liked that quite a bit. Where it was just like, if you want to live, let's just get out alive! Alright, so let's continue moving down. Undead and rock dudes. The theme for this year are undead and rock dudes. Alright. Wow, I am so surprised that there's a rock dude here. I never saw that coming. This looks like a quasi-important room. But, possibly not. And they're dead end over here. Dead ends sometimes mean treasure chests. And indeed, I have proven myself to be intelligent. Many piercings? My immediate question is, where do the mini piercings go? Oh no, how will I ever get past this? I have solved the puzzle, you guys! What are you doing, game? That was German. That's what that was. Can't. That's obviously a one way. I can only get to that from the other side. Break on through to the other side. Nothing that way. Nothing that way. Whew! I almost got myself caughted. So let's save real quick. If we save, we may have found the boss of this place. I don't have the key to open that door. I need a key now? But I was all excited about having found the boss. And then you tell me I need a key. That's rude, game. I will find the key, though. I will tell you that much. The key will be a thing that will be found by me. Oh my goodness, it's green. Whatever could green mean? Hello? Hello? That one actually confused me for a second. Why is Earth green? Apple gel. I both really like and really dislike the fact that, you know, they make their own remedies in this game. It makes total sense, but it also, I just feel like, you know, that's just one less thing that there's less preparation. You just run around, you know? I always sort of like going back to town and just completely restocking, like, okay, I'm ready to go. And now sometimes I get caught in battle with, like, very little supplies because I'm just used to them doing it for me. Now, does this go back up? Or does this continue down? It goes back up. So the question is, where is the key? I have not been this way, and so maybe the key is like down in this bottom little hidden room that's not very well hidden, because it's on the map. They're both green. There's that guy. Trying to be my friend. He can't be my friend. Now, how in the world did Rose get past that? Guys, I will be back when I discoverate the key. Because it looks like I'm just going to continue. These guys just apparently follow you forever. Because every time I look behind me. Okay, no. I thought maybe whenever they were out of sight, they'd get like a burst of speed or something. Because I've definitely had them sort of catch me in places. Hi, kitty. Can't go that way. So I feel like I have not been north from the save point. Is this the key? Gold key. And now I can open these. Hallelujah. Okay, I am slightly seeing the difference. In the dark it's hard. So I'm gonna run this way and just see what's up in this top room and then go back to the room you need the key for. I was gonna say, I see that. Hello, Void. Holy crap, I have a lot of topaz swords. Hi, kitty. I hear you. You say meow meow. Well, here's one dude. Sure, why not? Almost forgot to quick save. Huh? Not what? Oh, because his name is Not. No, Not. That's his name. Another mutant Hellion that rises from death over and over and over again.
Not what?
Okay, so it's undead. And obviously I have something that's working as undead. Left and right. I don't know what that is, but I have got to start stopping it. Okay, do I have anything here that's against undead? Phantasm Flash is. Sir, I just used that like 7 times. Now once again I have to figure out, do I have anything here that was against undead? No. Okay, what was it with this one? Because I remember it was something really easy. Yeah, left and right. You need to get Rose back up right now. Okay, good. Everyone was up. We did it. Again, I always feel just a little bit unsatisfied whenever I kill one of those guys, because there's nothing here, there's no point to it. I mean, why did I do that? I killed a knot, and that's awesome, but there's no plot, there's no story, there's no nothing. It's just, oh, here was a boss fight, hey, you won. Good. Ah, can't go this way. Have to go the other way. I'm just wondering, if he went back in here, is he back? Because they said that he, you know, is a dead specter that just keeps coming back. So I was wondering if he would just keep coming back. But apparently not. Apparently that is not a literal thing that he does. At least not right away. I'm sure if I come back later, because I do know these places sort of repopulate over time. Show... I was expecting something to be out here, since they specifically made me leave and come, like, go in there to get the key. So is there another boss on this side? Is this like a dual boss temple? Because it's just, there was nothing at the knot. It was really just him, there weren't any treasure boxes behind him or anything. And all the treasure boxes are here, and so you could just take them without fighting the knot at all. It's weird. Holy crap!
What a nice mirror! It's beautiful, opulent, but with an understated elegance.
Yeah, you can just imagine the kind of person who would own this.
For a relic like this to remain here untouched, this place must be entirely unlooted.
Yes, sir.
Well, it was.
I know you only have one filter for everything.
I wonder if the person buried here is a woman.
Yes. She's probably the one who owned that mirror.
Oh. Oh, so this was a grave. I'll be putting this back.
That's probably best.
Hey, do seraphims show up in mirrors?
No.
They're not vampires.
Usually not. But if we concentrate, we can make ourselves appear.
Wait, so you mean even people with no resonance can see seraphim that way?
Somehow, yes.
That's great. You could use that to communicate with humans.
That might be difficult. It takes enormous amounts of concentration just to show up briefly. Anything beyond that is impossible.
Just concentrate harder.
That's a shame.
Huh, so that explains it. People always whisper about ghosts that only show up in mirrors. Those had to be seraphim.
Yes. Sometimes when we're putting makeup on, we accidentally focus a little too hard and...
Putting on makeup?
Well, I mean, I am a girl.
And I go right back to looting. Well, that's kind of awesome. That, what a way to get the gold key and finally be able to open these things. It's like, here's all of the money. Damn. I'll take it. Okay, so I could be ending the episode, but I actually really want to know what the deal is with Pendrago and the snake I keep fighting. So I'm going to Pendrago, and I'm going to find out about the snake I keep fighting. And then that will end the episode. Next time, I promise we will keep going, and I will hopefully not keep running into crap. I mean, not that I've been minding the fights, they've been interesting, they've been fun, and I've been actually relatively competent at them, so that's always a plus. But, I've been trying to move on with this quest for, our, you know, Storyteller of Time for several episodes now, and I keep getting sidetracked by other, like, the game keeps distracting me from playing the game, guys! Okay. So the question becomes, well, there's some obvious stuff going on. Personal histories of priests and nuns of the church. I'm elated by your interest. The records are all archived on that bookshelf. You're welcome to browse them any time. I myself have spent many a candlelight evening lost in their limitless wonders. I assume it must be in this bookshelf. The one with all the... Enid Fortin, eldest of the Fortin sisters. Oh, so each of them... It's not the same one showing up over and over again. It's just like a series of sisters. Pleasant, cheerful nun. However, she engaged in a relationship with Father Eric and bore an illegitimate child. Both were excommunicated from the church and exiled to Horsha Village at the edge of Zafgat Moor. Rodine Fortin, the middle Fortin sister. So that was the one that was like, how could you choose her over me? Now, with great compassion and sense of service, some of the faithful refer to her as the saint. She approved the land reclamation project in the Fajbuk wetlands and would relocate there with a group of believers. For details on the land, please refer to another resource. Runette Fortune, youngest of the Fortune sisters. This is one I don't know anything about. Eloquent nun, rich in knowledge, made her name as a reformer in church politics and financial affairs. Following the disappearance of Pope Massendra, she demonstrated a number of miracles, leading her to the election as cardinal. Went down the Fortin sisters of the village of Fortin, located in the Glaverd Basin. Okay, so no, that was Cardinal Fortin. It was extreme poverty, and suspected the sisters were strongly pressured to make their vows in order to reduce the number of mouths to feed.
I can't believe it. Both of the Medusa-type hellions are...
They're probably Cardinal Fortin's sisters.
Are you sure? It seems like too much of a coincidence.
Well, the only way to learn the truth is to ask the hellions themselves.
But how?
If we're right, then I'm guessing they've gone back to their hometown.
A gut feeling?
Sort of, yeah. Just a hunch based on how humans think.
Well, it's not impossible, psychologically speaking.
Halfway logic is better than no logic at all.
And Rose's gut hasn't led us astray yet.
But we can't go there right now. Glaven Basin is currently closed off.
So, we'll have to sit tight and wait for an opportunity.
Oh, that sucks. I wanted to go. I was actually going to extend the episode to find out about that. Okay, it doesn't matter which one you check. Same info. Oh man, that is terrible. I wonder if the Cardinal spirit will be there as well. Or will it just be her sister's? Oh, I really want to know about that now. Rose, tell me it's open. It's supposed to be somewhere in the Glaver Basin. If we head there, maybe we can uncover something. So it is acting like I can. Guys, I apologize. This is going to be a long episode. I want to know this. I mean, I'm actually, like, super interested in this storyline right now. And I'm not stopping. Possibly this is because I'm recording this right after I finish streaming, and I'm just ready to go. I'm roaring, you know? And maybe I'll make it a double episode and just, like, randomly cut it somewhere. I don't know. Don't ask me. Don't ask me hard questions. I'm just going to be doing stuff. Okay, I was half wondering if there'd be more scenes about the Medusa now that I'd killed them both, but apparently not. Save point travel. Levard Basin. Those are both locked off. I really don't quite understand why I can't just, you know, walk past the army, be like, dude, I'm the shepherd. I won this hand battle single-handedly, I'm walking this way. Move. Levard Basin has been blocked for the entire flippin' game. Have you already been here, man? Or have you always been here? Your love was kidnapped with a hellion with the face of a lion? So I'm assuming I'm going to run over here and they're going to be like, no, you can't come in. I'll be like, aah. Yeah, they don't look like they moved. That should totally work. Wow, this seems to last longer than it used to. Ah. That's annoying, guys. I totally want to get in here. But apparently no, you're not allowed to. And Rose, what about the kids? I've also been really interested in the kids forever, too. God damn, Rose, hurry up! That's literally been going on for 20 episodes. Alright, well, unfortunately, that does mean that I'm going to end the episode, because I can't pursue this lead any further. I understand why it's like that, but it's also really frustrating that it's like that. I'm like, why don't you let me resolve these quests when I come across them? Other than 'cause you're a jerk. So I will go right back to where I started the episode, and I will end it. And I will see you all in the next one. Thank you very much for tuning in. See you next time, guys.